इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ आर स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर, सो इट इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ 3 स्क्वायर प्लस 4 स्क्वायर, सो इट इज अंडर रूट ऑफ 9 प्लस 16 अंडर रूट ऑफ 25, सो योर आंसर इज इक्वल टू 5 ओम. सो इम्पीडेंस फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर सर्किट इज 5 ओम. नाउ इम्पीडेंस इज नोन टू अस, वैल्यू ऑफ वोल्टेज इज ऑलरेडी गिवन. So now we have to find the total current of the circuit. So E is equal to 110 volt, Z is equal to 5 ohm. So our total current IT is equal to E divided by Z. So it is equal to 110 divided by 5 ohm. So our answer is 22 ampere. This is the total current passing through the RLC series circuit. Now IT is equal to 22 ampere, R is equal to 4 ohm, X is equal to 3 ohm and Z is equal to 5 ohm. Now we have to find the various values of power. First is the true power or real power, which is equal to I square into R. Value of I is 22. So 22 square into 4 ohm. So your answer is 1936 watt. This is the real power which is due to resistive element. Second is the reactive power, which is equal to I square into X. X is equal to 3 ohm, I is equal to 22 ampere. So your reactive power is 22 square into 3. So your answer is 1452 VAR. This is the reactive power due to inductive and capacitive element. Third one is the apparent power. So apparent power is equal to again I square into Z. So it is equal to 22 square into 5. So your answer is 2420 VA. This is due to impedance of the circuit. So one is the real power, which is due to resistive element. Second is the reactive power, which is due to inductive and capacitive element. And third one is the apparent power, which is impedance of the circuit. Now we have to find the power factor of the circuit. Resistance of the circuit is already given, which is 4 ohm. Impedance of the circuit is already known, which is 5 ohm. So value of power factor, equation of cos phi is equal to R by Z. So power factor is equal to R by Z, which is equal to 4 by 5. So it is equal to 0.8. And this is the inductive circuit, so it is lagging power factor. So 0.8 lagging is the power factor for a given circuit. So this is the RLC series circuit. Now we are discuss about series resonance. Now we are assuming that one resistance, one inductor and one capacitor is connected in series and one supply voltage is given, and if we are assuming that the frequency of voltage is vary from 0 to infinity, and due to the change of frequency, what happened to the circuit element, that we have to discuss in series resonance. In general, if you are change the frequency from 0 to infinity, at some particular instant it will happen that value of XL, which is depends upon frequency, and value of XC, which is also depends upon frequency, for a particular value it will happen that XL is equal to XC. So whenever this thing will happen, XL is equal to XC, this particular value of frequency is known as the resonant frequency, and the phenomena is known as the series resonance. So now we are discuss what happen in series resonance when XL is equal to XC. Now this is the basic information for RLC series circuit that we are discussed earlier. This is just a revision of this. So inductive reactance XL, which is equal to 2 pi FL. So it is directly proportional with the frequency, which is equal to omega into L. Capacitive reactance XC, which is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC, or you can write down 1 upon omega C. So it will indicate that your XC is inversely proportional to the frequency. Now when XL and XC, when XL greater than XC, the circuit is known as the inductive circuit, as we had discussed earlier. And when XC greater than XL, the circuit is known as a capacitive circuit. So total circuit reactance XT is equal to XL minus XC if it is inductive circuit, or XC minus XL if it is capacitive circuit. It depends upon the value of circuit elements. And the total circuit impedance Z is equal to R square plus XT square, or you can write down is equal to R plus JXT. XT is the net reactance of the circuit. So this is the basic information for RLC series circuit. Now from the above equation, for an inductive reactance, if either the frequency or the inductance is increased, the overall inductive reactance value of the inductor would also increase because it is directly proportional to the frequency. This means then the inductive reactance is proportional to the frequency and is small at low frequencies and high at higher frequencies. And this demonstrated in the following curve. As XL is equal to 2 pi FL, if the value of frequency is less, obviously value of XL is equal to less. And if the value of frequency is high, the value of XL will be high. The same thing will be drawn in this particular curve. So, on the x-axis, it will represent the value of frequency, and on the y-axis, they will represent the value of reactance. Now, as shown in figure, as your frequency will increasing, according to that, the value of reactance is also increases. So, this line indicates that your XL is change with the change of frequency, and it is directly proportional to the frequency. So at low value of F, your XL will be low. At high value of F, your XL will be high. So XL is directly proportional to frequency, and it will change from 0 to particular value of the frequency. Now, the same thing is also true for a capacitive reactance formula, but in reverse, because as we know, XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. So, if either the frequency or capacitance is increased, the overall capacitive reactance would decrease because it is inversely proportional to frequency. So, this is the diagram or graph in which you can see the change of reactance with respect to frequency when we are considered the capacitive element. Again, on x-axis, this is your frequency, and y-axis, this is your reactance. XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. So, when the value of frequency is less, the value of XC is high. And when value of frequency is high, the value of reactance is very less. So, the value of XC changes with the frequency, but it is inversely proportional to the frequency. At lower value of frequency, value of XC is high. At higher value of frequency, value of XC is less. So, in electrical resonance occurs in AC circuit when the two reactants which are opposite and equal cancel each other out, as XL is equal to XC. So, when XL is equal to XC, then XL minus XC is equal to 0. When this thing will happen, then it is known as the series resonance. And the point on the graph at which this happens is where the two reactance curves cross each other, which is shown in figure. When the two curves are cross each other at this particular point, you can say that XL minus XC is equal to 0, which is shown in figure. So this is the diagram. This straight line will indicate the value of XL, which is directly proportional with the frequency. And this curve will indicate the change of XC with respect to frequency, which is inversely proportional to the frequency. So, in this diagram, you can say that this is the point at which these two curves intersect each other. So this portion up to this is known as the capacitive portion, or you can say the value of Xc is always greater than XL. If you are show in this particular region, this is your Xc, which is equal to, suppose here 50, and this is your XL, which is nearer to 10. Same way, up to this point, value of Xc is always higher than XL. So up to this point, your circuit is behaves like a capacitive circuit. At this point, what happen? Your XL is exactly equal to Xc. So XL minus Xc is equal to 0. After this point, what happen? If you are seen in the figure, after this point, suppose you are assuming this particular point, the value of XL is higher than Xc, and it is true up to the final value. So after this point, your value of XL is always greater than Xc. So this is your inductive circuit. So in this diagram, you can say this is the portion in which your circuit is act as a capacitive circuit. In this portion, it is act as an inductive circuit. And for this particular portion, XL minus XC is equal to 0. So net reactance of the circuit is equal to 0. So this is the graphical representation of XL and XC varies with the change of frequency. So we are considering the point at which XL is equal to XC, then what happened? Value of XL is equal to 2 pi FL, and value of XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. So 2 pi FL is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. So F square is equal to 1 upon 2 pi L into 2 pi C, which is equal to 1 upon 4 pi square L C. So it is equal to, F is equal to under root of 1 upon 4 pi square L C, or you can rewrite this equation like this, F is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root L C hertz, or omega R, which is equal to 2 pi F, is equal to 1 upon under root L C radians. The resonant frequency is the frequency at which the total impedance of a series RLC circuit becomes purely real. That is, no imaginary impedance exists, because as we shown in the diagram that XL minus XC is equal to 0 at resonance, so no imaginary impedances are exist. This is because at resonance they are cancelled out. So the total impedance of the series circuit becomes just the value of the resistance, and therefore Z is equal to R at series resonance. So this is the diagram. It will shows the impedance in a series resonance circuit. So this diagram, in this particular, this is your change in impedance with respect to frequency. In X axis, this is frequency, and Y axis, it is impedance. So up to the dotted line, this is your capacitive circuit. So Xc greater than XL. After the dotted line, this is your inductive circuit. So XL greater than Xc. And this point is the point at which XL minus Xc is equal to 0. So this is the point at which your Z is equal to R. So this is a purely resistive circuit. Okay, so this is the representation of RLC series circuit in a normal frequency, and this is the representation of RLC series circuit at resonance. As we had discussed earlier, at resonance XL minus XC is equal to 0. So in this circuit, this portion is shown as a short circuit line, means X is equal to 0, only resistive element are there. So this is the representation of RLC circuit at resonance. So this circuit is act as a purely resistive circuit. No reactances are present in a circuit when F is equal to FR, means F is equal to resonant frequency. This is one more diagram. It will shows this is again our frequency and this is the current of the particular circuit. So this diagram will show that at resonant frequency your impedance is minimum. So it will indicate that if your impedance is minimum, means oppose of current is minimum, so the value of current is maximum. So this point will indicate the value of current at resonant frequency, and which is equal to maximum current. I is equal to I max. The frequency response curve of a series resonance circuit shows that the magnitude of current is a function of frequency, and the graph shows us that the resonance start at near to zero reaches maximum value at the resonance frequency when I max is equal to IR, as shown in the earlier diagram. The result of this is that the magnitude of the voltage across the inductor L and the capacitor C can become many times larger than the supply voltage even at resonance, but as they are equal and opposite, they cancel each other. As we had discussed earlier that XL is equal to XC, so at resonance VL and VC having very large value, but they are cancel out each other, so VL minus VC is equal to 0. You may also notice that as the maximum current through the circuit at resonance is limited only by the value of resistance, a pure and real value, the source voltage and the circuit current must therefore be in phase with each other at this frequency, because the circuit is act as a resistive circuit only. Then the phase angle between the voltage and current of a series resonance circuit is also a function of frequency for a fixed supply voltage, and which is 0, because this is the resistive circuit. So phase angle between voltage and current is 0, so the phase angle is 0 at the time of resonance. If the phase angle is 0, then the power factor must be unity. So at resonant frequency your power factor is also having a unity value. So this is the diagram. The first diagram will show the inductive circuit, second diagram will show the circuit at resonant frequency, and third diagram will show the waveform after resonance. So this point, at this particular point, this is our purely resistive circuit. For this region, this is our inductive circuit, and for this region, this is our capacitive circuit. So this is the explanation of resonance, how the circuit